me, Country Girl, and as promised, I'm going to start doing some cooking videos for you guys. I know we talk a lot when we're having our coffee with Pawpaw, and I've mentioned a lot of stuff I've done, and people have asked for some videos, so we're going to give it a shot. Today, I'm going to show you how to make a really super simple lasagna. It is one of my husband's favorite dishes, and a lot of people are intimidated by it, but you really don't have to be. It's not as hard as people think. So the first thing we're going to do is show you what it is you're going to need. So if he will follow me, first you're going to need a 9x13 pan. I have sprayed this with some cooking spray. The reason I do that is because when you cook the lasagna, you don't want it to stick. This is going to make it so much easier to get it out of the pan, and it's going to make your cleanup a breeze. You're also going to need some mozzarella cheese. This is fresh mozzarella, comes in a ball, and I just sliced it up. But you can easily use a block cheese and shred it yourself. Mozzarella, if you use the block, you'll need about 1.5 to 2 pounds, depending on how much cheese you like. Some grated Parmesan. Again, you can substitute this. The Kraft cheese that you get to put on your spaghetti that comes in the little bottle, it will work just as well. You're going to need 2 eggs. You're going to need a 32-ounce container of ricotta cheese. Can you see that? Ricotta. You're going to need some sauce. I have some leftover sauce from a meal we did previously, so that's what I'm using. And you're also going to need some lasagna noodles. And they don't have to be fancy noodles. They don't have to be expensive noodles. It's still going to be great. Now, you're going to see a lot of people parboil their noodles when they make lasagna. I don't. And I'm going to show you how to do it where you don't even have to do that. So this is really just a layer it and put it in the oven. Y'all ready for this? So let's get started. First thing you're going to do is mix your ricotta. So I'm just going to dump this entire container in here. Well, I think I am. There it goes. Two eggs, just put it right on top. You just take a fork, is the easiest way I've found to get this done. And you just kind of want to start working it together. You're loosening up that ricotta, getting the egg blended in. Doesn't take too long usually. Want it to get nice and creamy, get the egg all absorbed. Once you got the egg absorbed, for the most part, you know, you have a little bit left in here to go through, but we're going to add some cheese to this. Once you got that, you're going to go about 1 to 1.5 cups of the Parmesan. There's really not a need to measure here. You just kind of till it looks right, or if you like cheese, you really like it cheesy, then add a little bit more. If you don't, add a little less. It's okay. But the Parmesan kind of gives it that smoky, nutty flavor that just you can't replace. You know, it just makes it really, really good. Okay. Now, give me just a second. I forgot to grab something. I will be right back. Okay, sorry about that, guys. I forgot to get this, the one of my ingredients that I needed, and I just dropped it in here. Was just a little bit of salt. I don't put much in here, just a little bit. You don't need much. Cheese is pretty salty to start with, but this is a lot of pasta that we're going to have to season. So, now that you've got your cheese mixture done, we're going to get started on the layering. I'm going to take a little bit of the sauce. You don't need a whole lot on the bottom. Doesn't have to be a real thick layer. This is just to keep everything from hitting the glass. It kind of insulates it so that nothing on the bottom will really burn. It's the only really reason you need sauce on the bottom. Besides, it just tastes real good, right? Then you're gonna put a layer of your ricotta. going to use about half of this across here and half for the next layer. So and just take the back of your spoon, spread it around like any cheese. This is going to get melty gooey, so it's going to spread itself out a lot. Just want to get it somewhat smooth across here. I am nowhere near into perfection. I know there are people that are, and I applaud you for it, but I don't have the time or the patience for it. So, that's just me. And now the noodles. You're not going to need two boxes, let me tell you now. But I had a few left from the last time I made this, so I'm just going to use up the rest of these first. You don't really have to cook your pasta. And I know there are people out there, they're going to start screaming at me. But I'm telling you, you don't have to. You just want to put them together, overlap the edges just a little bit. I can get four across on a 9x13. And this little strip here, I just kind of eyeball it. Doesn't have to be fancy. Well, I guess I won't use that piece, will I? Good enough. Now here's how you don't have to cook your sauce, your noodles. Make sure that those noodles are completely covered. Anything that is not covered by sauce is not going to cook, okay? Y'all need to make sure they're completely covered. Again, it doesn't have to be a thick layer. Just needs to cover, because this is really a lot when you get all these layers together. Hopefully I left enough for the top layer. So, once you get that done, put a little bit of your Parmesan. Doesn't take much, and I'm going to leave the rest of that for the top. And you start right back to the ricotta. I'm going to use up the rest of this. Now, if you don't want to make quite so big a batch, you can absolutely do this in a square pan. Cut the noodles in half, cut the amounts in half, but you can also really take this, it freezes really well. What I do is I put the whole thing together when I'm going to make two or three and freeze. I put it all together just like it is. I wrap it really tight in foil. Stick it in the freezer. Don't cook it. Leave it raw. Stick it in the freezer. Let it come to a hard freeze. Once it does, get some foil. Tip this out onto foil, frozen. Wrap it three or four layers tight. You can also put it in a big Ziploc bag if you have one of those giant ones. And it freezes really well. When you go to cook it, when you take it out of the freezer, cut the bag off. Cut the foil off. Put it in the pan to thaw, because once it thaws, you'll never get it out in one piece. So put it in the pan to thaw. And then you just throw it in the oven and bake it just like you would any other frozen lasagna. You don't even have to let it thaw. You can do just like Stouffer's. Just takes longer to cook. Okay? So now we're going to go with one more layer of noodles. The top layer, I don't typically take all the way to the edge because I want to make sure that they're really well covered and I can get the sauce down in there around them. You can, by all means, if you want noodles end to end, go for it. But I like to be able to have a place for that sauce. So, we're going to get the rest of the sauce on here. Pay particular attention to the edges. Ooh, I might not have made enough sauce, y'all. Well, it's going to be close, but that's all good. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to make up another little small batch of sauce real quick. Let me do that. I'll be right back, and I'll finish this off for you.
Go.
Okay, I'm back. It didn't take but a minute. Let me tell you what I did. Part of the thing with cooking is learning how to think on your feet. So what I did is, since I didn't quite have enough leftover sauce, I took half a can of tomato paste, one small can of tomato sauce, about 2 tablespoons of an Italian seasoning blend, some garlic powder, maybe half a teaspoon, and a tiny dash of sugar and salt and pepper. I whisked it all together. I threw it in my microwave and blended those spices with it. And then I pulled it on top and I added it in and swirled it into the meat mixture. And as you can see now, I have a full pan of sauce. Took me 10 minutes. And it's not going to make a difference in the world. They're the exact same spices I used to make the sauce in the first place. So, once you get to this stage, you're going to sprinkle some Parmesan. I really like cheese on mine. I'm a big Parmesan person. So, let me grab my grater here. And I'm going to just grate some fresh on here, because I really like it. Again, this is all seasoned to taste. You know, if you don't like a lot of cheese, don't put it. If you don't think that's enough, then feel free to load it up. I mean, there is no right or wrong way to do this. Like I said, it's really simple, and you can easily make it your own. All right, now for the topping. If you're using the shredded, then you're going to want to just completely cover the top, okay? If you're using fresh like I am, just kind of put these pieces in here, spread it out somewhat over the top, because this is real mozzarella. It's going to be really melty and it's going to spread itself out, so it shouldn't be an issue. So just wherever you can fit this in here, just fit it in. There is no rhyme, no reason, guys. Some people like to make cooking just all about the science and the technicalities, and I'm just not that way. I'm a real simple country girl. I can throw it in a pan and I'm done. And that's my favorite way to cook. So, now that's all put together, you're ready to go in the oven. This is gonna bake at 350 degrees for about 30 to 40 minutes, depending on your oven. Just keep an eye on it. One thing I will tell you, you're gonna wanna make sure, put your pan, ooh, that was hot, I had it on my oven. Put your pan on a cookie sheet, because if this leaks, you don't want to have to clean this out of your oven, right? Okay, so I'm going to get this in the oven. I have my rack set right about the middle of the oven, so you get a really good even cook. We're gonna set our timer for 30 minutes and I'll check it, and we'll be back then and I'll let you know how it tastes and we'll cut it into it, okay? See y'all in a bit. Hey everybody, as you can see, it is out of the oven. Here it is, bubbly, ooey gooey. And what you're gonna wanna do, take a fork, go straight in, check your noodles. If they're not quite done yet, just put it back in for a few more minutes. This one ended up taking roughly about 45 minutes, maybe, give or take. So all you have to do is check it. So we're going to let this cool for about 20 minutes. I'm going to pause this And I will come back, we'll cut into it, and we'll take a bite and taste it out for you. Be back in a few. Okay, guys, this is it. It's time to taste it. Oh my goodness, you guys. This is thick, gooey. I love these crisp edges. Yo, first piece is always the hardest one to get out. There you go, and you guys see that? Sitting here for about 25 minutes, and as you can see, it is still bubbly hot. So, there we go. So let's taste it, you ready? It is so good. You guys have got to taste this. It is creamy, cheesy. The noodles are just cooked to perfection. Oh, y'all got to try this. So leave me a comment. Let me know what you think. This is actually, like I said in the beginning, my first video. So let me know what you think. And do me a favor and hit that like button, that thumbs up, and subscribe to my channel for more. Thanks for watching, you guys. Have a great day. Bye-bye.